everyone, this is MJ with MinIO, and welcome back to the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. In this video, we're going to do a complete walkthrough of the MinIO lab, and that involves installing MinIO on Kubernetes with the manifest files. In this specific video, we're actually going to do a K3D install. If you're looking for the K3S install, there is another video on this channel that you can go and check out. Or if you're using neither, make sure that you are customizing the files to suit your particular environment. Here's a quick walkthrough of the lab steps we're going to go through today. So first, we're going to download the MinIO Kubernetes YAML file, and we're just going to take a look at the default file. But again, it's likely that you're going to need to modify that. So step two is to modify that YAML for your specific environment. You're going to need to take into account the underlying persistent volume storage that you're using and modify it to suit that. Next, we're going to deploy the MinIO Kubernetes YAML file and actually get MinIO up and running on the system, and then verify that those pods are actually there and running. Next, we're going to create a node port service for the console and the API. The instructions on the website do say that you can use a port forwarding method, but I found that to be inconsistent. And so what we do here is just create a node port service that allows long-term persistent access to this deployment without having to worry about bringing up that port forwarding system. Lastly, we're going to access the MinIO console and access the MinIO S3 API with the MinIO client. So let's jump into the lab environment. So here we are in the lab. Let's go ahead and make sure we are on our K3D cluster. So we'll do kubectl get nodes. And we can see that we are actually running our 6 node K3D cluster. Remember, K3D is actually running Docker containers to emulate nodes, but this is more representative of what an actual production deployment would look like with multiple highly available server nodes and many agent nodes running. Next thing we're going to do is go ahead and download the YAML file as it is on the MinIO website. So we can see that we just downloaded minio-dev.yaml. Let's go ahead and take a look at that file real quick. If we take a look at this file, we can see that it creates a namespace, and it also creates the MinIO pod with certain specifications. Now, the place where this is going to come in that you'll need to modify this is that this is referencing local volume, but we don't have a local volume provisioner for persistent volumes on our K3D cluster. We're actually using something else. So we need to create a custom file for this particular deployment. Let's go ahead and do that now. We'll say nano minio dev custom. And we will go ahead and put in the file that we've previously created. And I'll walk you through what's actually in this file. So we can see that we are still creating a namespace, and we are still creating the pod in the same way using the latest image. But if you come down here, we've now updated our volumes to use the MinIO local path volume and created a PVC called MinIO local path PVC. And within that PVC, we are specifying our local path storage class that's available to us in our K3D cluster. So that's the important piece that's changed here. We're also asking for 50 gigs of storage on that local path provisioner. Again, make sure that you are using the proper storage class, otherwise this will fail. And also make sure that you have the space that you are requesting. My particular system here does have 50 gigs available to provision to me, but if you over provision, if you ask for more than is available, this will not work for you. Let's go ahead and save this. And now we can apply this. And now we can see that the namespace was created, the pod was created, and the persistent volume claim was created for this deployment. Let's go ahead and make sure that our pod is actually up and running now. First, we can actually check to make sure that the namespace got created. And we can see that it did. So we ran kubectl get ns, and MinIO dev is here now. Next, we can take a look at our pods. And we can see that there is one MinIO pod and is in the running state. And lastly, let's go ahead and check to see if our persistent volume got created. And we can see here that the claim name is MinIO local path PVC, and that it did create a 50 gig persistent volume based on that claim using the local path storage class. So that looks good to go. Next, we can take a look at the pod itself. Let's go ahead and describe that pod. And we can see here that we ran kubectl describe pod min.io in the namespace of min.io dev. Make sure that you are specifying your namespace, otherwise it might not find it. And we can see here that it's using the data from the min.io local path volume that we defined, and that this pod is up and running as expected. Lastly, let's take a look at the logs for this pod. And again, we can see that the output from the min.io pod itself, so this is a running min.io server, says that this is up and running, but what it's specifying here is the internal pod IP address. And so now we're going to need a way to access this from outside the cluster, because this is only inside Kubernetes, and you cannot easily access this directly from inside that pod using this IP address. So don't try to access it here from your web browser. It will not work. We'll need to do another step to make that actually accessible to us from outside. As I said before, we're not going to do the port forwarding here. We're actually going to create a node port service that actually lets us access this. So let's go ahead and do that now. So we are going to create a service, actually two services, that let us access the UI and the API. So here we're creating a kind of service. We're pointing it at the min.io dev namespace, and we're selecting the app min.io from the label selector. Next, we're defining a type of node port, and we're saying port 30,000 outside on our host should map to port 9090 inside, which is the min.io UI. The other service that we're defining here is for the API service, so min.io API service. And again, we're selecting the same pod, but that pod has two ports exposed, 9090 for the UI and 9000 for the API. So in this case, we're pointing 30,001 to our API port of 9000, and that will allow us persistent external access to our deployment here. So we'll go ahead and save that file and apply that. And we can see that now two services were created, and we should be able to access this now from our server IP, our actual machine IP, and port 30,000. So let's try that out. So here we are in our browser, and you can see that I've defined my external IP. Remember, this is HTTP. We have not loaded any certificates in, so do not try to use HTTPS. And 30,000 has brought us to our UI. Let's go ahead and make sure we can log in. And we were able to log in successfully. And let's create a bucket and make sure that this is working as expected. So we were able to create a bucket, and let's go ahead and also upload a file. We'll go ahead and upload a 100 meg file to this. And that worked successfully. And we should now be able to also download, make sure two-way communication is working. And it was able to successfully download that 100 meg file as well. So that is the UI portion of this, and we've confirmed that that is working. Let's jump back over to the terminal and now connect up our min.io client to this deployment as well. So here we are back at our terminal. Let's go ahead and make sure that our MC client is actually working as expected. We'll type mc --help, and we can see that that command works, and it shows us all of the commands that we can run using MC. So now what we will do is we will add an alias for our new deployment to this. So the command is mc alias set. We're creating a new alias. We're going to call it Kate's min.io dev. We're pointing at our server IP 30,001, because that is the node port that we pointed to our API inside the pod. And then we're using our credentials of min.io admin to access this. And you can see that that was successfully deployed. And now we can actually go ahead and test this. So we can first check our server. Run mc admin info and our alias name, which was Kate's min.io dev. And you can see here that uptime is 6 minutes, and that we have one drive, and that there's 100 megs used because we uploaded a 100 megabyte file. Next, we can actually check to make sure that we can access this. So we'll do a mc ls against Kate's min.io dev. And we can see that there is a bucket in here now. and let's see if we can see what is inside this bucket. And when we look inside that bucket, we can see that we do have our 100 meg file here and available to us. So that's everything for deploying MinIO using the manifest files on a K3D cluster. Hopefully that shed some light on how all of this works and you learned something from this video. We appreciate you watching. And if you're looking to deploy this in production, look out for future videos where we are actually going to show you how to set up the MinIO operator on Kubernetes to have a multi-tenant deployment running on Kubernetes. Thanks for watching. Talk to you soon.